take control, I was going sources. And in that was a desire to find another way to think about it, another way to think about myself, another way to think about talent, another way literally to think about everything. And I remember saying to myself, listen, pussy, stop asking yourself what the least you need to do is and start asking yourself how much you can bear. I began to develop a growth mindset. I needed to believe that by working really hard, that I could get better at anything. And if that were true, then I just needed to buckle down. I needed to practice. I needed to get good. I needed to do the reps. I needed to put in the effort. I needed to be willing to break myself in half to get so good that people can ignore me. The way to do that, act. That's it. You need to get out there and do right now, today, literally, stop this fucking video. And whatever it is, if you already have a passion, you are so much farther ahead than the vast majority of humankind. If you know what that thing is, get out and act. And by the way, if you don't know what it is, act. That's the only thing you're going to find out. Go encounter stuff. Go try things. It is in the process of action that you're going to learn the things you need to learn. But if you've been thinking about something, let's fucking start it. Like, actually, go try it right now today. You'll learn more infinitely more in the process of trying to create it and make it real than you ever will by watching videos, by thinking, by meditating on it, by taking notes. None of it compares. It's not even in the same universe. It's just community. One step is better than 100 hours of pontification. Running 100 miles an hour in the wrong direction. It's better than standing still. You'll learn something. So get rid of this notion that you're going to end the day with a perfect record. You're going to fail. You're going to fuck up. You're going to try 1,000 things, and 999 of them are not going to work. But whatever you want, really, don't ask yourself who you are today. Ask only who do you want to become, and then are you willing to pay the price to get there? And people are convinced that they shouldn't act until they have it all figured out. Fuck that. You should act right now today, no matter how chaotic your vision, no matter how chaotic your life, no matter how much you have going on already, you're working two jobs, three jobs, doesn't matter. Taking action today is another way.
Is out there, and with over 2 million of today's most talked about podcasts available, Spotify is the best place to find the one you love. Whatever you're into, get way more into it with a podcast. Find the one you've been listening for right now, free on Spotify.
We so often focus on failure, don't we? We study failure, successful failure. We dissect failure and our failures. Dissect them so much we end up intoxicated with them to the point of disillusion.
Your future is never predicated on what you lost. It's predicated on what you have left.
Most people never dare to evaluate really where they are. And they don't know where you are before you can really determine your chances of getting what you really want out of life.
There are many more ways to fail than to succeed. We're a rocket. There's like 1,000 ways to think you fail and like one way it could work.
It's hard for people to be themselves. They don't like themselves. They don't like what they are, so they like to pretend that they're something more exceptional.
Compare yourself to who you were yesterday and not to who someone else is today.
When you don't get what you want, then a landscape of questions emerge.
There need to be reasons to get up in the morning. Your life can't just be about solving problems. Otherwise, what's the point?
And those questions can resonate through different levels of your identity, from the trivial, oh, I told the children, to the profound. There's nothing desirable about me and I'll be alone for the rest of my life.
Responsibility is appreciation of the past. It's building of a lineage. It's investing in ourselves. It's investing in something we started to build yesterday that we want to take into tomorrow. That gives us freedom.
What you have left is enough to build something greater than where you are. And you have all the rich experiences that come through the atrocities you survived.
They looked at the most successful men and women of the world, and they found that they had like 7-8 things in common. And one of the things they all had in common was a routine.
Failing to prepare was preparing to fail. The night before a game, I ate the same food. I went to bed at the same same time. I got up, I ate the same breakfast. So the routine and the preparation, some people call it superstition, but it's a routine.
The stronger your mindset is, the greater your skill set is going to be.
We remember the stuff we earn, the stuff we experience more than what the teacher tells us or what someone gives us for free.
A company is simply a group of people. As a leader of people, you have to be a great listener. You have to be a great motivator. You have to be very good at praising and looking for the best in people.
If they want us to read, just to be read, the majority of you are poor because you read poor stuff.
Everything was done to try to learn how to become a better basketball player. Everything. And so when you have that point of view, that literally the world becomes your library to help you to become better at your craft.
I think it's important that you really like whatever you're doing. If you don't like it, life is too short.
If I'm lying to you about who I am, or I'm lying to you about where, there's no starting point. There's a false reality. You have to create the real reality.
It's a good separation for me, emotionally, to be able to put myself in a place where at practice, when I'm training during games, I switch my mind to something else.
I became number one in the world. I became a millionaire not because I made more money. I became a millionaire because they told me millionaires only live off of 30% of their income. I became a millionaire because I did what man ever did. I stopped living off 100%.
What does it mean to have this money? How do you multiply time? How do you buy time? Rich people buy time.
Most of the people watching this thing should either not be in business if they've got one, or close the down if they got one. Because you got in business for all the wrong reasons, and you don't have the balls to close them down. Because of what other people are going to say. You have no idea how limitless it is when you're not afraid of what other people think or say. You have no idea. There's not two people watching this thing that even has a concept of what it is to act as if you have no limits to your abilities. Zero. But you have to do something every day that scares you. And that's a takeoff from Helen Keller, who said, or not said, she was deaf, dumb, everything, she couldn't do anything. And she said every day she did something to scare herself. Well, if you and I had all those afflictions, just getting out of bed would be scary enough. And so I decided that one of the differentiations between the people that got the most out of the week-long seminar and the year-long free mentoring for me is people that really press themselves hard. So I translated that into they've got to do something and listed what they did to scare themselves every single day.
Is that the essence of really what you do, is getting people to take no risk, to get out of their comfort zones, and then the wealth comes later?
It's not just out of the comfort zone. It's the change of reality.